Okay, so now we have all the accessories to look at. We'll start with the shield, which is just a normal strike shield. It has a little slotted piece to cover the window there. The movable handle here. And you got this part, which it'll just rotate. It doesn't actually come apart because where the strike had the elbow piece to like lock it in, this one doesn't. So you basically just have to have him hold it in his hand and hope for the best. Which, it doesn't really work that well, but it's, I guess it's there, but this blue frame never actually used that shield, so I'm not really having a problem with that. And then we have the beam rifle, which is just the Astray beam rifle. I lost the clear piece, but this kit comes with some stickers for the bazooka, so I just bought it in there. Got the movable handle. And it does have the hole. And since this is just the same kit, it pegs in fine. No problems there. Although, once again, this blueprint never used the Astray beam rifle. And left over from the strike are the armor shiners. Which, if you want to use them, you can. There's nowhere to store them, but you can use them. And then we also have the beam saber handles, which you don't have any beams that are for this the beam saber, so unfortunately they are not useful. They're nice for show, but you can't actually have them displayed on the kit, like in the hand, being used. And then they do give you the toe blades that the blue frame second is known for, which is cool. I kind of wish they were silver, but black is okay. And you also have the heel ones, which very hard to get out. See, that's what usually happens. You can just kind of hit them in the right spot so they can pop up, but then you just push them back in and they click into place very nicely. So they're not going anywhere, which is good. Now let's start looking at the new stuff with the new backpack, which was pretty good. I'm over there for a second. Okay, so yeah, it's pretty nice looking. I have the missile pods on, which have the nice chrome for the end. The missiles are individual. You can pull them out, but it's very hard once you have this whole thing assembled, so it's not really easy to get them out. And unlike the old Nails of War version, you can't really pop them out. Now, these little parts in the back that can kind of open, not much. This part opens for whatever reason. You've got these ball joints that connect the missile launchers, but also the ones in the at the base. Now, they kind of lock into place. There's little grooves, but it's really hard to keep them in there. These ones here are very loose, so it's not easy to knock them off. And these ones here are very tight. Just pull them out some, and then they can rotate. And they can just push them in and lock them, because there's also a little tab that goes into some grooves. Then you have this little claw thing, which is used to mount the beam rifle in the back for storage, which is cool, because, you know, nice storage. Now, speaking of the Nails and Works, very, very different looking backpacks. Very different. And also, very different kind of connectors, as you can see. So, this one here does fit easily into the blue frame. You can have this rested on the back, but I'm just going to unpay it all together. It's not really necessary. But it will fit into the back. It also goes into the two holes where the beam sabers were held. In the instructions, they show you actually putting this on with the beam saber handles in there. You can't. And with that, it's a super secure fit. And the backpack is not going anywhere. Let me just get the blue frame standing. He is more back heavy now, unfortunately. There you have the missile pods over the shoulders, which it does look nice. It's a little back heavy now, but not as bad as it will be soon. Now you've also got the small missile pods, which I really like the clear green and the gold to match the other ones. They look pretty nice. And comparing them to the Nails of Earth, definitely smaller, and once again, these have the opening hatches, but this one doesn't. And they'll just tab into the new armor parts that are put on the lower legs. Like so. And they fit very securely. Now another thing you have is the blue frame second L is known for. And it does have some articulation. You have a double hinge arm inside the gray piece here. which lets it come out, and then it can rotate. But you also have opening flaps on the wings themselves, which, I mean, I don't see any thrusters in there, so I'm not sure why they do that, but they do it. It's unique. And this will just peg into the hole in the back skirt. Like so. Which actually kind of helps the back skirts, the original ones, kind of stay in place. It kind of locks them in there, so that's nice. Now, if you don't like the missile pods, the big ones on the back, you can actually take these adapter pieces and put them in the hand. So you just have to take off the connector with the ball joint that was on the backpack. Pull it out. You've got two holes, which you'll just peg these into. They do seem to go a certain way. And once they're in there, they're very secure. It's kind of hard to get them apart. But now... Oh, and one of these fin things came out. But now you can have them in the hand. Which... It's not the best. It's not terrible. You can kind of get them to, like, wrap around. Yeah, that's not too bad, really. They're not going anywhere. They're kind of heavy for missile pods, but as you can see, the blue frame can hold them. And then another accessory that comes with the blue frame 2L are its own unique daggers, which... Oh, like, it's common for the 2L, but I love the fact that you actually get chrome on the edge of the blade. It's very unique. Could have just simply been black. That's all it had to be. And they also fit nicely into the holder. And they just fit onto the new parts that are mounted on the thighs. Like so. So that's quite a lot of accessories already. I think it's pretty nice. But... You actually get quite a few more, so I'm actually going to stop. I know this is taking a while, but there's a lot to go through, so I'll see you all in part 3.